Good day students, welcome to a new class of digital documentation. Today we are going to do session number 5 of the unit 1, that is implementing of mail merge. Now let us understand what is the exact meaning of mail merge. A mail merge is a way to take a letter that you have written and send it to a whole bunch of people, personalize it with information about them so that they might think that you have typed the letter personally for them. Now, let us understand it better with an example. Suppose there is a letter which you need to send to multiple people. The content of the letter is remaining the same. Only difference is that it will be personalized to each person individually. Now, if you want to write such a letter and you want to send it to 1000 people, it is a very cumbersome task for you to write or type the letter 1000 times only by changing the name of the person whom you are addressing the letter to, or some other details in the letter. So in such a case, we can create one document or one letter, which is the main content document, and only replace the name of the person whom you are sending it to and personalize it for that person. So this is, and so how we can combine making a mailing list of the number of people whom you want to send it to and one content letter and merge the two together is the concept of a mail merge. Now, a mail merge can also be a quick way to take a list of mailing addresses and generate labels or envelopes with the address of different people on each label or envelope. So, with the help of mail merge, we can also create mailing labels. When you get envelopes which have got pre-pasted labels, then typing this label and the addresses thousands of times may become a very difficult task. So, mail merge helps us to create envelopes or labels with predefined addresses of the sender. So, this is basically what is the concept of a mail merge. As we go further, we will be able to understand this concept much more clearer. Now, so let me give you some examples of mail merge. Now, if a principal or a teacher wants to send letters to all the parents regarding a meeting or an annual function, the content of the letter will remain same to all, only the recipient details will change. Similarly, if a company wants to send details of a new product launch to all its existing customers, then the details of the letter will be same for all the customers. The only thing that is going to change is the customer address or the customer name. If you want to send, now taking an example for the envelope or a mailing label that we want to create, suppose we have a wedding card which we have designed and the wedding card is pre-printed, only change that we need to do is the envelope will contain the mailing addresses of different people, so or the whom you want to send it, so you can stick those label, only you have to generate those mailing labels and stick it onto the wedding card envelopes. So this way we mail merge helps in reducing our time and efforts to send the same letter to different recipients. So let us now understand how we will have to do this mail merge. Now, for the purpose of mail merge, we require two important documents. One is the main document, which is the content letter or the form letter, which contains the actual document or the letter which is going to go to multiple people. So this is going to be constant, which is only a single letter. Now the next is the data source. The data source is the address list of the people whom the letter needs to be sent to. So this is called as the data source. So how many other people, suppose 500 people need to be sent, then the names and addresses of the people whom you are going to send, 500, 1000, 2000, how many other people you want to send it to, that will become your second document, which is the data source. Now this data source is a database which consists of the names, addresses and all other details which form one record, which is a mailing list to be derived. Now data source can be a simple, it can be made in a simple spreadsheet, a normal text document by commas separating the name, address, etc. with commas, or any other database like MySQL or Access, Oracle or any other open database source, that is ODBMS. ODBC, any database document can be made into a data source. So in today's class, we are going to learn how to create this main document, how to create this data source and combine the two together and make mailing letters as well as envelopes. The first step for mail merge is to create a data source. Now first we are going to create a data source, and this time we are creating it in the calc data source, that is a spreadsheet. So I have already created this data source in OpenOffice Calc. I'm opening it with OpenOffice Calc, which contains, it's an Excel sheet. It contains title, first name, last name, the building number and the house number, area and city. I have entered details of 5 records in this particular Calc sheet and I have named it as address.ods. So this is my spreadsheet which I have created and which now I am going to link to the to create a mail merge document. Now I close this. Now we are going to open a new text document. To link the external data source that we created, that is the spreadsheet, I will click on the file option, then click on wizards and then address data source. Click on this option and in this here, see, it gives you the message OpenOffice lets you access data already present in your system. To do this, OpenOffice data source will be created in which your address data is available in a tabular form. So these are, we need to actually get this address book from an other external data source. So I'm clicking on this other external data source, our external data source. Next is, then click on settings. And now what is the data source that we are looking for? We are looking, our data source is a spreadsheet. So as I told you, we can make, create different data sources. Here we are using the spreadsheet as our data source. I click on the next button and then I want to click the name of the file or the path where the particular data source is present. So here I click on this and the name of my file I had already selected, that was address. I click on open and see here the address.ods, the calc file which I created is there now on the address bar, that is the path. Now I click on test connection. I need to click on this test connection. So it will say the connection was successfully established. I click on finish button and then click on the next button. And here if you want, I can give a name. Now for this address1.odb, this is in my documents file. Location it will be saved if I want to change it and click, keep it on the desktop and I want to write a, give a name to it. I can just change it as new address or something like that. I'm just giving a name to it, new ad. And my address book also, I want to make it as student address. I'm just giving. So now the address book is saved on the desktop. I'm giving it a name as student address and click on finish. Now my file has got, is ready to be, that is my external data source is now ready to be connected. Now I have to create the main document. Now the next step is to create the main document, which is the letter which I am going to send to the parents. So here I click on 2. I am just making the form letter for you. 2. This here is the name of the parent or the address. Dear sir, madam. And I'm writing the letter over here, subject, or you can just write, this is to inform you that a PTM on, let's take 14th December at 5 p.m. on Zoom call. The link will be sent to you. So I have created this. This is the letter which I am going to send to the different, to the parents. Now what we need to do is we need to insert the different fields that we have created the data source. We need to insert the fields over here. Now for that purpose, I need to first view my data source. So I click on view option and click on data source, and here see by default automatically the table which I had created, it is coming over here because I had linked it to this address one, that it is called sheet one, and this the names which we had created, that is automatically come over here. Now here I need to click the first one. I will drag this and bring it over here. Title space first name, drag it again, give a space and the last name. Now the last name field, I'm dragging it and bringing it here. Press enter. Come to the next one, house name, enter the area, enter and the city. So now these are the fields which needs to be changed every time. So my form is ready now. Now the next thing that I need to do, so here this only the addresses will keep on changing, the remaining letter will be the same for all the people. Now here if I want to include over here instead of dear sir, madam, if I want dear Mr. Miss, and I want again the first name or last name here, that also I can insert over here. Now it will be dear Miss the last name. So this way also I can make it. Now what I need to do is I need to print this. So when I click on file and print option, it will say that your document contains address data fields. I click on yes, and now it will tell me that do you need to print all the records or from a particular record. Suppose I want only from roll number 1 to 50 or record. Now in this case it is all the record. Now if I have a printer which is directly connected to my computer or a laptop, then if I click on printer, it will directly print the letter. Now in this case I want to save it to a file, so I click on file. There are two options in which the one is I save it to a single document or I save it in individual documents. So suppose if I save it to a single document, then all the letters will be in one single document and I can later on take the printout. If I want it as individual documents, then I can click over here on save as individual documents, and while generating it, what name do you want? I want, let's take the first name or the last name or the as my name, and then where I want it, I want to click it inside in this particular here, or I can click over here in path and select wherever I want those individual documents to be there. Inside documents I want, I can create another folder of say mail merge, and then in this I can by first name I can save it and say okay. This is if I want individually each letter in a different file. In that case I can, this is or all the letters I can put it in a single file, single document, and just take the printout of that. That also I can click over here and do it. Now here it will be according to a simple single file. I click on okay. Now I give a name. I am clicking on the desktop only, and then I'll say final mail merge. I'm giving it the desktop, I'm saving and say save. Now you, when I minimize this and go in to my final mail merge and open this file, I'm not opening it in Word. Yeah, here it's opened in Word, but I can open it in here. Now the first one to Ravi Saxena, the second is to Geeta Rai, the third one is Mr. Peter John. Like this, the same file has got saved, and I can simply take a printout and send it to the respective people. So this way I can send a letter to multiple people using the mail merge option. So this is how to create a mail merge document. I can either do it, now in this case I did it to a single file. In the other option I can make a folder and save the individual letters as individual. So if I have got 50 students, then I will be having 50 files or 50 documents, each one containing one letter. So this is the way in which we can create a mail merge document. So our first method, that is to make a data source, how to create a data source, and we can also create a data source using a database option. That is, you can either use a spreadsheet, which we have done, or we can create it in the, or as a text file we can do it, or also we can create a data source using the database option, that is the OpenOffice database access. That also we can create in Access, Excel, any way we can create and create an address book. Once we have created the address book, like how I showed you, the next option is to merge the main document with the merging the main document with the data source. That also I showed you how to double click, pull it and place it in the place where you want to, dear first matter. And then we have to save the data main document as a merged document. So this is the method of using mail merge in and creating a list of letters. Now, after learning how to create a mail merge for a letter, we will now understand how to create a mailing label. Now, labels, as I told you, are predefined address name and address blocks, which we can print on predefined labels. Labels, generally the paper available for labels can have pre sticker labels, which you can just take it out from the paper and stick it onto the envelope or on any letter that you want to. So how we will create this type of mailing labels, we will understand in detail. Let us now see how to create mailing labels. Now, labels are nothing but addresses which you can stick onto envelopes. You must have seen that if you want to stick envelopes and on the top of the envelopes, you want to stick the labels of the addresses. How to create that labels using this, the mail merge option, is what we are going to learn now. So, here we again open up a new document, click on File, and in New option, we will click on Labels. Now here, whatever is currently there in this, we have to delete it. Here we have three different tabs: labels, options and format. Now we first click on the labels option, and in the database we need to select the database which we had created. So we can click on the address or the database that we had created last time. In our last example, we had created the database, the Excel sheet, the spreadsheet called address. Click on sheets, and in that we had the following fields. So we had already created the spreadsheet by the name address in OpenOffice Calc, and in sheet number 1 we had given these fields: title, first name, last name, house, building, area and city. Now one by one we are going to click on the field, and this arrow key, we are going to transfer it to the label text area. So here we have got the first one, that is the title, a space, the first name, again move it to this side, one space more, and the last name, move it. Now we have to press the enter key so that we come on the next line. And the next field is the house name or building, the enter key, the area, again move it to this side, enter, and the city. So now our label text is ready. Now here we can either have a format of a continuous one or in different sheets. This is the area where we can select the brands. There are different brands of labels which are available, and depending upon the brand we are selecting and the type we are using for the labels, we can select any of the different options. These are like the paper types, like how we have A4 size, legal size, A3 size paper. In the same way, labels also have their different brands and types. So we can select it from this particular option over here. Next is we click on the format option, and in format option we can also have customize our own labels according to the height and the width. Suppose you want to increase or decrease the height or the width, we can do it from this option according to the label size that we have. We can even customize it according to our needs. From left margin, you want to leave margin areas, and if you want it in two columns, single row, all these details we can do formatting of our label from the format option. The last part is options. We need to click on this synchronized content area so that we can synchronize the addresses in the label. So these are the setup. If you want to set up the to print to a PDF, we can also do it. Now we are as of now, we are just simply going to create, make it as a new document. So I click on new document and my label, all the details, that is the title, first name, last name, the house area, all the details have come here in this particular format. The next thing that we need to do is we need to print this label. Exactly like how we did the mail merge, we will click on file and we will click on print. Here again it will tell your data document contains the data fields. We click on the yes option, and once again your data, the sheet which we had already created with the 5 records, is available to us over here, because we had selected the address spreadsheet as our data source. This address spreadsheet, we had created it in OpenOffice Calc, and we had created this Excel sheet in sheet number 1. So this data automatically, because we have selected it, it automatically comes here. Now we want all the, whether we want all records or any of the only certain labels, we can print according to the record number. Suppose I want only record from 2 to 5, so 2 to 4, or maybe 2 to 100, or whatever it is I want, I can select it from a particular to a particular record number. That also can be selected from here. Just as I already previously told you, you can also click directly to the printer and print the labels on, if you have input the labels onto the printer, or we can save it onto a file. Last time I showed you how to save this onto a single document. When I was doing mail merge, I showed you how to do it on single document. This time I'm going to show it to you how to save it as individual documents. Now click on individual document, and how the file name has to be there. We are giving the file name as first name, and where I want to save it. Let us see, I want to save it on the desktop, and in the desktop I have created a folder called mail merge. Already I had readily created a folder called mail merge. I will click on that mail merge and select that as my location. So it is going to be on the desktop, a folder called mail merge, and the files, the labels will be as individual files. So this way I can select it and click on OK. Last time we had done single document, so all the letters were getting saved as a single document. Now this time we are going to use the second option. We can do even as single document, then all the labels will come as single document. But since I already showed you our single document, I'll show you how individual files will look like. So save as document and click on OK. Now the printer, 5 of them have got. Now we will minimize and go to the mail merge document, and you will see 5 different labels with the names of the students, the names as the first name, because I had given it as first name. The file names are also first name. I will open it with OpenOffice Writer or with Word, and you will be able to see the individual documents, and we can get to see the label. Yeah, this is the first label, and in this way each individual label will be in one. Now I did not give any margins, so it is come right from the top. Otherwise I can customize my label according to my label, the label which I am going to take the printout on. So this way I have got 5 different labels and 5 different as 5 different Word files. In the same way, you could have it as a single document also. So these are the 2 methods in which we can save our merged data. That is, the labels have got synchronized and they have created as different ones. In the previous example, we had done in our previous mail, final mail merge, we had mail merged it into a single document. So all of them were coming one below the other instead of separate documents. So this is the 2 ways in which we can print our merged data. So here, this is the way our mail merging, this is how we have done labels. I already showed you how to do it, the method of doing it exactly. This is the labels format option and how we have to print labels. This is the continuous sheet. All this I have explained it to you practically. So we have understood how to prepare for printing and how to print mailing labels. So with this, we come to the end of this particular chapter on mail merge. There is also another method of doing mail merge, that is mail merge through the wizards. That is another very simple way of doing, but the syllabus covers us methods using the external way. This again I already covered to you, printing in a single file or printing in different files. All this I have covered to you practically. It may look very complicated when you read through the PDF, but when you go through the watch the videos, it will be easier for you to see how this has to be done. Here the activity they have given here for you to try: type a letter to your friend inviting her for a party you're hosting, for example the anniversary party. You pick up the event, your letter, you should save it as a mail merge letter. Then they have given you the how to create it, what are the ones you need: title, first name, address, city and pin code. These are the fields that then you need to create as a data source. So you can create either a database a table, or you can create a spreadsheet. And finally you are going to use the data source, and at least 5 families names you are going to give it, save it and merge the data, merge it as a mail merge document also, and also create mailing labels with the same data. So this is, so print one form letter and one label. This is what is the assignment or activity that you can try out for mail merge to practice your mail merge chapter. Now with this completion of mail merge chapter, we have come to the end of unit 1. That means we have covered all the 5 sessions of unit 1, and also we have completed the entire syllabus of for your examination, from your examination point of view. That is unit 1 digital documentation, unit 2 electronic spreadsheet, unit 3 RDBMS, and unit 4 web applications and security. So we have completed the entire syllabus along with the employability skills, green skills, self-management skills, entrepreneurial skills, and also I have sent you notes regarding ICT skills, which we had already completed fully in 9th standard, and the communication skills, which is just simply the grammar and communication skills. I have already sent you the notes regarding this, so you have to go through the notes and understand it. It's very simple, and also you would have got an idea about what, how the portion, how the syllabus and how the question papers are going to come for your IT exam with the help of the practice test. Now in our further videos, if possible, I will be covering up some important practicals which you may need to understand and do in case we have a practical exam. The guidelines for the 50 mark practicals part of the syllabus has yet to be decided by the board. As soon as it is available, I will be letting you know how it is going to be done. Also be ready for writing a project of around 15 to 20 marks regarding whatever syllabus we have covered. I'll be giving you detailed guidelines about it in the coming days. Now in the few later on the videos which I'm going to send you, it is going to be simply practice of the previous practicals assignments which I have done. The more important ones which may come as will be covered to you in detail once again in the following video lessons. So please go through the revision videos, please go through all the videos whichever has been sent for a better understanding of the IT 402 subject. Thank you.